Hello, I'm EnterElysium, and welcome back to From the Depths. So, let us have a quick look at the map. No one to attack us, but we have got loads of tasty resources nearby. So, if we have a quick look at our resources, you can see that we don't have all that much. I mean, we spent a lot of it building up for the fight, and a lot of the resources we got from the fight are just sitting over there in the depths. Well, I guess they're actually on the surface, I assume is where they died. We need to go collect them. Now, I did build a transport ship. You may have seen the building episodes recently where I built a transport ship that would basically be like a Uber Zeppelin carrier transport ship that would get our resources from A to B. Actually, we'd get millions of resources from A to B. It was completely overbuilt. You know me. That's what I do. But unfortunately, we can't afford to build it. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to use this old motorboat thing to transport stuff around. So let's just spawn it in. I would like boat, sweet boat. To play, and I will TP to it. And I need to fix this. Because this, I mean, we are going to be using it in a very short term, but I just know. Right, we need to improve this. We need to give it, what do we need to give it? A control, the controller, not a ship's wheel. I've never seen the point of the ship's wheel, really. It's got propellers on the back, it's got a rudder. That's fine. I mean, it could give it just a gigantic-ass propeller and be like, yep, screw it. It's very tempting. If I did that, actually, it would be here, which means it would be partially out of the water. Probably not worth it. Too fancy. These little missiles could actually be useful in a fight. I mean, the boat would die pretty quick, but it's not a terrible boat. Like, it's actually better than the previous dying boat that you used to have. What else do we need? We have some ability to, like, hold resources here. Not much. I think there is, like, some sort of resource-carrying thing built into the ship itself somewhere. I could have sworn there was. Oh, it's got fuel there. For its engine. And are these crates? No, they're not. Okay. Well, there we go. There we go. I knew there was something. And then you've got next to it a... Is that like a metal crate or is that scrap? I think it's metal. So what we should do is we should basically put more of these down. In fact, we should put some rather big ones of these down. Because I want to be carrying a lot more back. Right, let's put a partition wall. And I want to actually check what the cost is of the block I'm going to be making. So I want to go to... Raw miscellaneous storage crate. Oh, it's really cheap. It's like 40 natural. Well, there we go. We can carry a lot more stuff now. Right. And has that changed our center of gravity that much? They're empty. No, it hasn't. It's just we're rolling a lot anyway. Well, damn it. Oh, well, let's give her a whirl. I can't imagine this to go particularly well, but... Let's try. Right, so... You may be getting seasick. That is certainly a possibility. Oh my god, look at that top speed! Yeah, we're so fast, we're gonna get there in no time. Oh, actually on the back we have some resource things as well. I'm not sure what they are. They definitely aren't normal. What are they? What are you? What are you? Let's interrogate. Oh, it's a wood block. Huh, it's just a different design. Okay. I would like to put a mirror line down. And then I would like to go water, boat propeller, huge propeller. And if I put it there, I'll need to chop a little bit out of the back, so... There we go! Isn't that better? I mean, you know, we're not perfectly balanced, like we're diving in and out of the water. What we need is to build the... Yeah, this boat is getting more and more elaborate. It was just meant to get us there, but... Me, I happened. That is a problem. It's a terrible thing. Effectively... We could just build some of this up. There we go. And we're still diving a little bit, which we shouldn't be doing because it's the problem with the center of mass isn't perfectly in line. I should probably get our building mode and check where we are. Oh, we picked up a load of resources. I leveled up from picking resources. Awesome. I'm going in the wrong direction. Okay, just a bit further to the right. Starboard, starboard. See, I know my nautical terms. We'll get this one and we'll turn around. Come on. There we go. Right, turn around. And return! Right, let's find out why we're diving. Because people ask me this quite a lot. Basically, it's like, why do you have to put the propellers in a certain place? It's because they need to be in line with the center mass, or you end up nosediving, or you end up bouncing out of the water, which is what we're doing at the moment. So what we'll find is that center mass is perfectly in line. That is weird. Why are you bouncing then? It might be just because we were bouncing when we started. If we cut the engine entirely... It's the bounce of the waves, I think. We're just coming off the top of waves and coasting to the next one. The sea does look choppier. Like, I normally have the sea choppiness turned down because people can get motion sick from it. But it does seem choppier than I remember. I just have to check if the options have reset that or something. Options. Gameplay? Field of view, 90, blah, 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 blah. Gameplay 2. Wait, yeah, I've got that turned down. Are we out of fuel? Yes, you have fuel, right. Why is your engine not working? You have fuel. At least in theory you do. Maximum power output. Why is your max power output? Have you overheated? That might be it. No? Oh god, there are more numbers here than I've ever played with before. Fuel usage per second. Normalized fuel usage of power output. No. Just say no. Why are we not moving? There will be like a really obvious thing, but for the life of me, I don't know what it is. We have fuel, but we don't have an engine. Why? Overheated. It says it's overheated. Operational. Okay, there we go. We've gotten back. By basically rebuilding them. Yeah, I know. It's somewhat of a cheat, but... Yeah, sue me. We've actually got spare space here. So what we could do is we could put, like, an exhaust. Or we could just put a radiator. You know what? I'm just going to chuck radiators on the side. Like, I shouldn't really do this because we're going to be deleting this vessel or leaving it to die relatively soon, but... I'm a sucker. Large radiator. We can't fit that on. It's going to have to be a radiator. That's probably fine. Is this just a hole? Oh no, that's a block there. Okay, I see what they're doing. I could always like put an exhaust that just comes out here, but oh, no, I'm lazy. Right. Fast forwards. Why can I see those resource bars? I thought you could press R to get rid of them. Oh, is it because I'm in build mode, probably? I can't get rid of them. Yeah, that makes sense. Right, let's get back, dump the resources. We've got a few resources now, but still not quite enough to build the Zeppelin that I want to build. I might have to wait for another attack. Which is fine. Come on, little boat. You can do it. You might want to get behind the... thing, because I don't really want you fighting. As much as you have like a weapon that, yeah, it's reasonable. If you get hit, you were just going to like, boom. That would be bad. Right, yep. Get you to slow down. Build mode. Right, if I hit R, yeah, bars disappear. And I want you to give to Home Sweet Home. Transit is 100% of the resources required by the fleet it's supplying. Low oil. Sure. Q. keep. I want you to keep fuel. I don't know who I'm selecting anymore. All right. Oh God! Like merge these forces together. What? Well, I don't know what's going on. I want to select one person and be like, keep fuel. But right, who have I selected? I've selected the starting fortress. I don't know because this guy's still green. Right, that seems to make more sense. Okay. Right. I want you to keep none of these. Keep spare parts at about 50. Yeah, screw it. Keep it full. Keep full ammo. Keep full energy. The rest you can get rid of. And you, I want you to... Well, I just want you to take it, I guess. Now, in theory, if we look at you, you should have, like, nothing in your cargo. Why do you have natural metal, oil, and scrap? You just haven't given it away. You've been filled up with it. I don't really understand this. Why are you not giving it away? Right, we can see the bars right here. Your metal is increasing. In fact, I think you're being fed by Home Sweet Home. You must be. Give to Home Sweet Home. Take from Home Sweet Home? Right, you are now getting resources. Okay, so why weren't you giving them before? You should be. You just aren't giving anything. I'm not sure why that is. Fortress. Keep everything? Oh, finally that worked. Okay. I'm not sure why I needed to do that. Odd. Are you still giving? That's a lot of stuff to give. What is it you're giving? Natural? At 20,000 a click. And then metal at 20,000 a click. What the hell? That's a lot of stuff. We've filled up our inventory of natural and metal. Wow. That's a lot. We now have a quarter of a mi- That explains. I always thought that was low. Yeah. Okay. Very well. I think this means we can build our Zeppelin, and I will detach the camera. Since we're building a Zeppelin, we should probably build, like, a little bit of a dock type thing. Probably extending from this pole. Effectively, we need to make this pole out of metal, because, well, we need it to be out of metal. Like, we don't want it just going, boom, you take out one block, and, the entire thing goes down. I mean, admittedly, that happens with metal, but... For start, we're going to make it out of probably a bit more than one thing of metal. And also, wood dies really quick compared to metal, so. Whee! Boom. Right. I'm going to place that there. And... Right, so that should mean that... Provided you don't take out, like, this block, or you don't take out both at once, this should hold together a lot better now. And in terms of an actual dock, it doesn't necessarily need to be an air dock, because the Zeppelin can start low to the ground. It doesn't matter. What it does need to be is have repair tentacles, have stuff like the spawny thing. Yes, I'm going to call it the spawny thing. I can't remember the life of me what it's called. And a tractor beam, which is actually called a docking station. Yeah, we'll build it out the side of here. Why not? So, miscellaneous. Repair tentacle. And I'm using compact repair tentacles because, like, these are more expensive. They cost 30 more metal and they cost 15 more crystal. But they don't dangle around like these, so they look better-ish. You could argue they don't, but they also don't need physics for their tentacles, and that's kind of necessary because physics don't want to be using all the physics resources, especially for something so superfluous. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, let's do a bit more. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is going to take a while to build. And of course, I can't just spam, like, repair tentacles, because they are expensive. Well, more precisely, I don't have much money. You know, part of column A, part of column B. But let us get ourselves a not-sub-vehicle docking station. That is the one I want. Docking station. And then a... blueprint spawner. I would like you to spawn a distance of 30 meters. Hold until no limit. So I think blueprint release when it's being followed for 1 second and has at least 100% completion. Okay. Right, I would like you to spawn. Is it still in test? In progress, yes. It is resource blimp. I think it's version 3. So we need a 250,000 natural, 70,000 metal, quite a lot of fuel. Is that oil? That's oil, actually. 33,000 scrap and 1,000 crystal. We'll build it anyway. Build. And then resource blimp. I would like to hold you an azimuth of 90, so it's side on. And a distance of 30. And it's building! Right, so I have made a couple of changes since the building stream to this. You'll see them when we're done. I might just leave this thing to do its business and come back to you in a minute, because this is going to take a little while. And we're about 90% done, but the problem is we don't have any oil. I mean, we are getting oil, it is coming in, but it's coming in so slowly that this is going to take quite a while to finish. Obviously, we don't have any engines on the side. I think we're still missing some of the internals. I think we finally got the engine done. That took ages. I was waiting for a while for that one. I think it's largely because it seems to be spawning it in with, like, fuel tanks, which I think are full. Well, maybe they aren't. Did we give it fuel? We've got loads of fuel over here. Oh well, what we need to do is we need to get more resources. And I could spend a lot longer with this just out of play. But that, I've done it for a while and it's starting to seem like, you know, not necessarily cheating, but taking advantage of the time warp. Because you should always do the time warp. So what we're going to do instead is we are going to take this boat out, fight some enemies, and try and absorb them into our empire, and by that I mean just nick their resources. So land it. Yes. Do you think you're ready to go out? I don't know. I mean, what are the missiles like? Thruster, fuel, explosive, infrared. Sure. And the other choice is to give them, like, what are they called? Ejectors, and then make them torpedoes? I mean, it's certainly ejectors, right? I'm certainly feeling the injector system. Yes, we want to inject the missiles into you. That actually would work. They would be kind of explosive inside. But no. We want to just eject them so they go out a little bit faster. And sure, why don't we have two going a bit faster because they've got two ejectors. And are you AI controlled? I'm gonna probably guess no. I'm not on the base. There we go. That is a block of wood. Which means I can put my own AI here. Right, AI. Weapon controller. And AI mainframe. And I think I could also tell you to be a entirely AI controlled boat if I wanted. I mean, I will pilot in combat for now, but I could be like, yeah, just do all the stuff in combat for me. Because if I put a... Yeah, let's do it anyway, right? If we put a front back card slot here, and then put a naval AI, broadside below this range, leave broadside above this range and try to close nominal broadside angle, probably straight on almost, because I don't want to present too much of a target, so that's probably best. Minimum broadside range, if they get too close to our missiles, really, like, yeah, 85 is fine. Idle approach distance, sorry. Turning circle, yeah. Depth requirement, yeah, that's all fine, okay. Sure. Now, why are you not going anywhere? That is the question. Also, we need more fuel. If we're going to actually go out and try and come back, we need a lot more fuel than we currently have. Because you saw what happened last time. Actually, that was overheating, not fuel. Maybe I don't need any more fuel. It's fine, I don't need any more fuel. We've got enough ammo. I presume it was made of enough ammo. I'm not going to try and alter that. Engine won't overheat this time. Okay. We could make the engine more powerful, but do I need to do that, really? If I open the engine full up, we're not even using... We're fine. Oh god, no, I meant to stop. There we go. Okay. I don't know how much range our missiles have. I'm going to assume it's about 400. So, fight about here. Right. And begin battle. Right, teleport me. Go. No, way out of range. No? Are we? Apparently not. Two of our missiles are out of range. The ones with the bigger ejectors are actually fine. Come at me, bro. Nice. Ammunition spoil. Two damaged. I am pleasantly surprised. How cheap are these little starting ships? We maybe should make like a little fleet of them. Oh yeah, that is how it's done. What resources did you drop? 2,000 oil. You know, that's not a lot, but I will take it. I have no idea what the circle is. Oh, it's us going back to our fleet. Right, so yeah, go pull that. Yoink, nom 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 nom. I wish I could see how strong the enemy were in the next door sectors. I might need to get a satellite up. But let's bring that lovely oil home. Delicious, delicious oil. Right, are you... Yeah, you've got rid of all the oil. So let us spawn in all of these puppies, and then I would like to TP to... Honestly, I don't really care which. And then up. We should be able to see... There we go. I was wondering where the blimp was. Hello! Oh god, that's close. Oh, you're gonna be scared for a moment. We need to go to an altitude of about 20 so that we can get all the resource collectors working. And there we go, right. We're still lacking a fair chunk of oil. How much more do we need? 91%. We still need 9% more. Well, I guess this is enough for me to do a walk around of the ship. Hup! Whee! How do I get in? I did put a door on it. But let's just say the door isn't the easiest to get into. Right, let's see if I can do this. Come on. Gotta be really cautious. Right, there we go. Careful. Aha! The alternative is you can use a teleport to get in. So this is... something gonna be here? I don't know. Right, so this is the back of the ship. You can see it's got a fuel store down there. Fuel store on the side. Oil store up ahead. We have, like, 1 million natural, basically 1 million metal. Wait, is that 10 million metal? And 10 million, yeah, it's 10 million. 10 million natural, 10 million, 10 million, basically 10 million most resources able to be carried by the ship. Now, of course, I don't expect to get anywhere near that. For, this is probably going to do us for, like, the entire game in terms of carrying capacity. It's got this big engine, which is efficient. You can see we're using a mere fraction at the moment. I mean, I guess we aren't moving very much, but still. Ammo supply up here. Not because it's going to use it, but because it's going to give it to everyone else. Our own little command bit here with all the appropriate little things. Hello. If we go down below, you can see we actually have crystal growth farms that can hold like a ridiculous amount of crystal. I mean, how much can each of these hold? Can I find the ends under there, under the steps? But it's something like several thousand. If we go up ahead, more fuel. More fuel. Really? Just sitting here? Just, that seems odd. Okay. That's scrap. That's natural. Go up. There we go. Just random bits of lead here for ballast. Because I needed to make the ballast all like nice and equal. There we go. We have a refinery. Now, people have been mentioning you really shouldn't put a refinery on board because this is going to be traveling 100 meters, which means it's going to be not particularly efficient. Yes, that is a very good point. Now, the reason I am going to ignore that is because it actually has its own resource collecting potential. It can use these to get oil and use these to get resources. So basically, I can park this at a resource zone, and if we haven't actually put like a proper fortress there, this will still collect resources. So this thing can basically be independent. I mean, it can generate its own resource if you get it to a resource zone. It can refine its own oil to fuel, and then it can travel with that fuel. And its new engines, which you can see them being built along the side, these can get it to about 60 meters per second, same as the custom jet engines, and they use a lot less fuel. The problem is that they are a lot more annoying. The ship has to be perfectly balanced or they don't really work. Unlike the custom jet engines where it doesn't have to be perfectly balanced. These have to be a lot more picky. Which is why you can see there's just giant blocks of lead on the inside. So with these, it uses a lot less fuel. And in fact, I believe with its refineries going, it just about breaks even. Just about. And that's if it's moving. I mean, if it's stationary, of course, you're fine. Now, of course, it's only stationary when it's, you know, not in play. Because when it's in play, it's always moving because you can't turn these off. Not particularly easily. I mean, you can with action control blocks, but I need the ones up here going, and it would be complicated, and ugh. So yeah, it's kept in the air by these, which only just pull it off. It has emergency balloons on top, just in case it hits the water. You can see that we have our exhaust here. Left and the right thrusters. Pitch thrusters, and I don't think we've got any roll thrusters. Mainly because we don't really need them. Because we've got the ones in the top here, by the way, have the always up fraction set to 100%, so they always point up, which means that this thing just, it will always be upright if these are working. If they're not working, then we've got bigger problems. Yeah, you're going to take a little while long to build those. But this should be our long-term, I mean like really long-term, like I can't ever imagine really replacing this. Behind the scenes resource collecting barge, which is going to fly around and do its separate thing. It's 60 meters per second and completely independent of any fortress. This thing should be just, there is no reason to really upgrade it. I mean, other than say if it gets attacked, but it just shouldn't get attacked. The point behind this is it should stay behind the scenes and do its thing, transport all the resources around, and that is very important to the war effort, and I'm going to rename it. Force name. You are... Technically, are you a HMS, Her Majesty's ship? I guess supply ships can be called HMS. So I'm going to put the designation first. The designation is auxiliary, and then Zeppelin. I'm making this part up, and I'm going to call you transport ship. So AZT-1... HMS, and the name for the entire class is going to be Nigel Strubble. So the HMS, we'll just shorten that to Strubble, the HMS Strubble. Very good, I like it. Welcome Strubble, as our first ship of the game. I mean, the first ship we've created. It's still taking its time to be built. You can see that the oil is definitely a limiting factor here. Ugh. And the next ship we build will be probably just a little fleet of these puppies. Just to be able to get a little bit more resources by attacking my sectors. And then we'll probably build a militarized version of one of these blimps. I just like the idea of tacking guns onto it and making it fly at, you know, 300 meters and just raining death, because that just seems interesting. I mean, I like the hull concept. The hull is pretty awesome. But I've been EnterElysium. Enjoy. Please like, not subscribe. Please consider subscribing. Next episode, we'll try and build a little bit of a militarized fleet.